What's up, everybody? Main boat guy back again. Today we're gonna change Seastar helm. So on these, this is the tilting helm. A little more to them when you put the new kit together, but for the most part it's the same thing. So you're just gonna undo your two lines, then the four bolts that are holding the unit. Oil pads, oil diapers are good to use for this because she's gonna lose some fluid. I've already got these loose. I started without my camera. Mess we made. Thankfully we got oil pads in there. Alright, I'm getting the impact for these. I'll be back. Careful, you don't want to turn the steering wheel if you have it connected like me, because it's rotted right to it, because it'll pump the fluid right out that end. So we've got the old one out. I'm gonna unbox the new one next and get it installed. All right, we have got Seastar HH6541-3. Classic tilt helm. Basically got the bezel inside, obviously our instructions. There's the unit itself. Fittings, studs, nuts, steering wheel nut, and then these hold all the little bezel covers. So I'm gonna get the fittings on this first, match it up like the old one, get them in the same direction. We'll go from there. Then I'm gonna take this back out of the boat and put it on the bench. A little easier to work, huh? All right, so we got the old one here. I'm gonna match up the way these are sitting. Obviously this is the bottom because of the tilt on here. So we'll flip this one over, basically, so we're in the same position. We'll remove those two plugs. Allen head. I'm gonna go put some gloves on. So we don't get too nasty for getting in and out of the guy's boat. It's a good glove right there. High quality. Another reason for doing it on the oil diaper is there's going to be fluid in it from the factory when they test the unit, so I'm just going to get it out of there so I don't leak it when I go to get in the boat. All right. Make a mess on my table. Okay, the old style had just regular degree fittings, so basically you had to crank them to where you needed them. These are adjustable. Look at these gloves, this is insanity. This is adjustable, so once you thread it in and have it sitting at the right spot, then you can turn just this nut separately to tighten it down, so then you can put it at the right angle. You don't have to worry about cranking it, cracking it. Let me get another glove here. See if I can get a set of gloves that'll work here. All right, so in the same spot, so we'll thread this in. There are O-rings on it, so they don't need thread sealer, no thread tape, anything like that. That's a good thing about these new ones. So basically right there, that's pretty much all we can do besides take these studs and we can put them in there, but I don't think they'll stay in there, so get back in the boat. All right, we got the helm back in. We just stuck the studs through so we can get the nuts on the back side. If you notice, my camera's a little sturdier this time. I'm using the DJI Osmo Mobile 2 to hold the camera and to be able to adjust it and all that stuff without screwing around with anything. So hopefully that helps. Makes my videos look a little better. And then these don't have to be crazy tight, just snug. You'll feel it once it gets to that point. Just give it a little bit of a crank. They're a tapered fit, so they don't need a thread tape or anything like that. So that's back in. Everything looks good. This one zips it right up to that, so I'll put that back in there. We'll come back and check for leaks after we purge the system. So. Break the fire extinguisher. Suppose it's time we. Get the covers on that thing. All right, see what we've got here. Black gloves and this aren't going to match. This is the piece for the tilt. So that's just going to slide right on there, I believe. Probably going to go on after one of these covers. Let's find out. Oh yeah, she's going to notch right into the bottom of that. Been a while since I've done the tilted ones. And I'm not a huge fan of instructions. Downfall on my part, but that's just me. I would venture to guess, we're going to put this on first. That don't look bad. Not bad, boy. Nope, that's coming underneath. See that? We just land. That on first, this in there, and that don't seem right either. Sorry, I didn't get to show you that part, did I? Well, it was yapping to him. Basically, I put it in there from the backside and then turned it when it was in there. I can do it again. Might as well. It's an instructional video. That's what I did. That's how I did it. This end up in there. And then back into there. If you can figure out a different way, then all the power to you. All right. Wow. Okay. I was thinking it didn't come with the keyway, but it's right there, taped to the shaft. Oh, now we need small Allen head. So I'll go get that, be right back. So you got four screws holding the base, three screws holding this top piece. Don't tighten them all up yet until you get them all in, like I just did. Power purge junior hooked up to the engine. And the screw is loosened, connected to the helm, and then today I'm just using a regular booster pack because batteries are all covered and strapped down, so I'm not going to disturb that. So let's turn it on. Let's hope I got those steering hoses in the right direction. I'm gonna give her a little turn just to see. Oh yeah. I'm gonna give it 30 seconds or so to see how much of it will get out. I'm gonna stop bleeding. The squeaking is just as stupid. If you didn't watch my last video with steering systems, I love this power purge. That thing saves. I'll try and do a video next time when I'm not in such a rush to get the boat out of here, on how to do it by hand. Have to have a second person with me. But we'll go over that in a later video, in case you guys are doing it without a power purge junior, which chances are most of you are. We'll let that run a couple more minutes. Disconnect the hoses, tighten up the bleeder screws, and then we'll be right back, check the leak, show you how to do that.